Praise the Lord. I've come to help two categories of people. Catholics who are shy to explain their faith and non-Catholics who are asking, where is it in the Bible? And here I'm to use the scripture to explain the doctrines of church, especially the contentious ones that regards our mother Mary. Many people will always ask Catholics, where is it in the Bible? Where is it in the Bible? Well, as Catholics, our faith are built on two foundations, sacred tradition and scripture. The church existed before scripture. Scripture was given to us by God through the church. Okay, but in order not to worry, in order to help those who are always asking where is it in the Bible, I'm here to show you in the Bible some of the teachings of the church and other things that we find difficult to explain. Number one is Mary, the mother of God. Let me ask you, is Mary the mother of God or the mother of Jesus? Don't worry, I know the answers of some people. Some people say Mary is not the mother of God, she's just the mother of Jesus. But from simple reasoning or logic, who is Jesus? I'm sure the answer for us Christians is that Jesus is God. Then the next question is, when did Jesus become God? Of course, that question is useless. He did not become God. He's always God. John 1:1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So, if Jesus did not become God, it means that there was no point in time when Jesus was not God. And if Jesus is the person that Mary gave birth to, and Jesus is always God, simple reason, simple logic, Mary is the mother of God. Jesus is God. Therefore, Mary is the mother of God. Jesus is not man who became God. No. If he was man who became God, that means maybe the point that Mary was giving birth to him, he was not God yet. But he is God who became man. And Mary is his mother. Therefore, Mary is the mother of God. But let's see it in the scripture. Luke's Gospel chapter 1 from verse 40. Down, I will read. He said, she went into Zachariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. Now it happened that as soon as Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. I wanted to pause there. Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. Immediately she heard Mary's greeting, she was filled with the Holy Spirit. Now if you go to 1 Corinthians chapter 12, and in verse 3, the Bible there says, no one can say that Jesus is Lord unless he is driven by the Spirit or influenced by the Spirit. In other words, it takes the power of the Holy Spirit to confess Jesus as Lord. Now back to Luke chapter 1. Elizabeth was under the influence of the Holy Spirit. And the Bible continues in verse 42. It says, she gave a loud cry and said, that means from now forward, everything she will say is by the influence of the Holy Spirit. She gave a loud cry and said, of all women you are the most blessed, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Why should I be honored with a visit from the mother of my Lord? Why should I be honored with a visit from the mother of my Lord? This is Elizabeth under the power of influence speaking. The Lord, the word there she used, Lord, is a translation of two Hebrew words, Elohim and Adonai. The Jews refer to God as Elohim and Adonai, Lord translated into English. So Elizabeth is using the same word. So she's calling Mary the mother of my Adonai or the mother of my Elohim. If I want to read it in Hebrew, it will be that, why should I be honored with a visit from the mother of my Adonai or the mother of my Elohim? The same words used for God. So biblically, by the power of the Holy Spirit, Elizabeth has confirmed Mary as the mother of God. See, I'm reading from the Bible. This is my tablet. Luke chapter 1, verse 43. Read it in your own Bible and tell me what that means. So this completely settles the question. If anybody asks you, where is it in the scripture? If anybody looking for it, I don't show you now. If this explanation cannot help you to throw away your prejudices, then I don't know what else will help you. And if you are not comfortable with it, then the best you can do is to leave Catholics alone. Mary is the mother of God. It's our faith. It's our doctrine. It's our belief. Scripture grounds it. If you don't accept, then don't worry. Thank God Elizabeth said, the mother of my Lord. Maybe your Lord and my Lord is not the same, but my God has a mother. Her name is Mary, and she's also my mother. I heard that two Muslim guys were arguing. One was just looking for trouble. He came to his friend and said, Kai, Ustaz, these Christian selves, they say this
Jesus is the Son of God. How can they say Jesus is the Son of God? Is it true? His friend didn't want trouble. He said to him, what is your problem? If he's not the Son of God, is he the Son of your Father? In other words, leave them from what they have believed. Stop looking for trouble. So if you don't accept Mary as the mother of God, we will have accepted. I beg backwards, stop criticizing what you don't know. She's our mother, whether you like it or not. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Have mercy on us and on the whole world. O Father, have